Hey everybody, it's bazybeats coming to you on video from Tampa Bay. Been getting a lot of emails lately and people are asking me, what does it take to do your first gig? So tonight's video is, so you're doing your first gig? So what I'd like to say is, starting off, you have some considerations to make. If you're going to be going out and doing professional shows, you're going to need a way to get there. First thing is, you're either going to need to have some kind of a trailer or a truck with a topper on it or something like that, because you got to get your stuff there and you need it dry when you get there. And here in Florida we get a lot of rain, especially in the afternoons and the evening times, late evenings, so I find it's best to have something with a cover on it. So this is my trailer here, and let's open it up and see what it looks like, how we've configured the inside with my equipment from my last gig that I did with my acoustic drum set. So what we have here are my acoustic drums in their cases, and they're sitting in front of a very large box back here. I'm not sure if you can see it because it's kind of dark, but the box back there is holding all my equipment, such as the rack, hi-hat, stands, cymbals, my drum caddy, and an assortment of other just garbage. At any rate, the toms, I keep each one of my individual toms in a case like this. As you can see, very well protected, soft material all the way around. If you're going to do your first gig, you don't want to scratch up your drums, you don't want to mess up your equipment. I suggest keep everything individually wrapped, and then keep all your hardware and stands and things like that in a separate box, and that's what we've done here. So I'm going to go ahead and pull it out. Now this right here, it's another important piece of equipment to take with you. I do have my Mike Portnoy 12-inch snare sitting in one of those cases over there, but I take another snare with me. It could be any old snare, just something that'll work in a pinch, because if you bust a head in the middle of a show, you want something good that'll back you up. So I keep a second snare with a decent head on it, ready to go at a moment's notice. As well, I also keep an additional 12-inch head, snare head, ready to go that sits behind me at the gig. Nice coated professional grade head, so that in case both heads fail, I can still shut down the show and come back within about 4 or 5 minutes with another snare ready to go. Another thing you want to do if you're going to get a trailer or a truck and you're going to have anything on wheels, like I have this large case here, you need to be thinking about how are you going to lock it down. I'm using straps that are hooked to U-bolts into the walls of this trailer, and I'm using eye hooks, eye bottoms, to hook into on the bottom. This entire trailer did not come this way. My friend that owns Armor Case Company had to come in and totally tear out the walls in this thing and then put in new eye hooks and U-bolts all the way around, as well as he put some J-hooks up for me to hang wires and things on as well. Okay, so this is Big Bertha. This is my biggest box. It cost me about $700-$800 to have this box built, custom built by Armor Case Company. It's a good thing my friend owns the company. This carries all my junk that I need for a show. If you look down in here, you can see that it doesn't have to be neatly packed. You just throw everything you need in and you're ready to go. That includes my seat and all my stands, cymbal stands, rack, hi-hat stands, cymbals, my drum caddy, and my blower, my fan goes in here. This is a drum caddy. So you're doing your first show, you want to make sure you got one of everything. I'd suggest buying some kind of a toolbox on wheels, like I did with this Stanley. It has a couple of tops that you can open. I put in my different various jacks and cable ends and what have you on one side. I've got an assortment of drum keys. You can never have too many drum keys. You all know that already, I'm sure. On the inside, actually, on the inside, I keep extra beaters for the bass. I keep an assortment of the tools that I know I'm going to need, such as vice grips, Allen wrenches, an assortment of different screwdriver heads, and what have you. And never go anywhere without some kind of a flashlight, however small it may be. You get on stage, there's going to be a lot of dark space, and you're going to need to see something. Take a flashlight. This particular rig has a pull-out tray, and I keep extra felts. Can't have too many of these things for your cymbals and such. Extra wing nuts and screws that go on the end of the cymbals, and extra bolts for your heads and for the sides of the drums and the rims and what have you. Keep some kind of felt lockdown devices, straps and what have you, that you can put on different things that you need to maybe adhere to the kit. It also has a pouch here, and it also comes apart in the center, and I can even keep more things down inside. In this case, I took along with me some batteries because I do a lot of video and pictures. Markers are good to have. Some of you say, why markers? Well, I take a permanent marker with me because, and also take duct tape, everybody's friend, because you may need to mark off things on your kit and where it's going to go on the floor. Trust me, you may need it. Take the marker and the duct tape. Got an extra beater down here too. Another very important and vital thing for a drummer to have, and you should have one even on your first gig, is some kind of a fan. This is a small fan. It's put out by Stanley, and it was really funny because I found this at Walmart on sale. I think it was like $30, and as soon as I bought one, I started immediately seeing other drummers and musicians in general out playing with this exact same fan on stage. I went to the Vans Warped Tour this last summer, and I don't think I saw a single band, including Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, that didn't have these. And just about every drummer was using these, sometimes two of them. I use one. I do like to use two, but I've got one right now, and they seem to last for a very long time. Don't go anywhere without a fan. These are beautiful.